Hey guys, hopefully I'm live. Let us just make all the settings once again see. Yeah, let me just confirm it from my side whether I'm showing live or not, and then I will proceed. Because what generally happens is that when I am live, it takes me a few seconds to see myself live. That is what I want to do, because when we are live, we should know that whether it is. So, well, I'm just confirming whether I have got live or not. Let me check the software. Yeah, streaming is going on. So, yes. So, guys, welcome. I'm just confirming whether it is streaming or not. I'm live or not. Just let me confirm it from my side. Yes. Yeah. So, yep, I'm live. And how are you guys? Let me just do the sound correction, because yesterday also some problem was there with the sound. So, yesterday when I used the headphones, it will be better, right? Now, yeah, I'm using the headphones now. Okay, so hopefully now there will be no sound problem and the sound will be clear, right? So, guys, welcome to this course. Practice RC passage. The course we have started. It's a very short course where every day I will make you practice not much, two questions, maximum three questions, and along with it I will try to provide you a few of my tricks that are practically applicable from that particular time. More tricks are there that I keep on telling, but some of them I always talk about in this session, that is so that the entire lesson becomes very fruitful and very meaningful for you. So we are now in the third lesson, practice sentence completion, and tomorrow we have find the misfit sentence, that will be again your practice. Well, so sentence completion, what is the topic about? Before talking more about what this topic is all about, let us talk about a little bit about myself. I'm Bhagyashree Ghosh. I welcome you all. In this page you can see some of my credentials, okay, and the courses that I do have on the Unacademy. So these courses are to like, this link is there. You can go to this link and you can get all these free courses there, right? So you will be able to see all my courses there. And apart from it, Unacademy is also in the subscription model. I'm also teaching live on Unacademy Plus. Now, what about this referral code? Is actually Unacademy Plus has a subscription model where a learner subscribes with a limited amount and gets all the educators, all the top educators, live courses unlocked. Every day more than 30 live hours time is being spent, okay, by different educators. So new courses are published every month. And so you see that how the amount goes genuine in that case, because by one fee it is entire course gets entire all the educators courses live classes gets unlocked. Well, further 10% discount can also be obtained by using this referral code. So I do also have my courses there, and other courses are also there. My upcoming courses are going to start very soon, because the dates have a little bit confusion. So I will tell you the date that when my new course is also being started in Unacademy Plus Live. And firstly, though, very good afternoon all the learners. I'm just checking the comments. Maybe I need to refresh it a little bit to get directly see the comments. Yeah, now I'm seeing the comments. So that was though some part of the topic. Now coming directly to today's lesson, importance of para completion. Basically, it is not about importance of para completion. We are here going to learn certain things. We are going to see how the para completion works, what are the type of questions that in the exam that the exam asks, and certain tips practically that we can apply it just now and just now see some positive changes in the way we solve these questions. Well, para completion is one of those very important topic that has very good chance of reappearing. Why? Because three questions of para completion were there in 2018, even in 2017. And even in 2016, there were, I think, two or four, I'm getting confused, so I won't be commenting much on it. In 2016 also, para completion was there. So para completion is one of those very easy topics. I would say that if in the entire verbal ability, there is which topic that is the easiest one, I will say it is para completion. The only reason is it gives us a small paragraph, very small paragraph. We just need to read and then they will give us the options. We just need to select the right option and boom, it is done. Very less time taking, and mostly if our approach is right, if we know exactly what the exam wants and exactly how to solve it, we will be able to do that. So, very good afternoon, Utkarsh. Welcome back. So, let me just adjust a little bit the brightness from my screen. Yeah, now it's better. So, the topic para completion is also quite famous because it provides the options. We all know now that the CAT exam has certain topics. Example, the previous day when we were discussing para jumbles. Para jumbles, they were not teaching, they were not giving us options. Those were the TITA, which we also call it type in, type out. They don't give the options in para jumbles. We need to arrange it by ourselves and enter it in the box given to us through the virtual keyboard. Now here the para completion is one of those easy ones where paragraph is there and options is also there. And some of our verbal ability, the RC, some of the RC skills we can just directly apply here. So basically our mindset should be just the way we read an RC. What we do when we read an RC? When we read an RC, we try to see what? We try to see and we should see basically exactly what the author want the readers to know and remember. Author will provide a lot of facts, but that is not the main message of the author. Facts is though like something we can just Google it to know whether it is true or not. Author in any RC, if I say, want to give any message, like when we talk in general with our friends or anyone, in order to prove what we are saying, in order to validate our opinions, we support it with certain facts. We do it everywhere, even while writing answers in exams of schools and colleges. So this is to there. Any RC writer is also doing the same. Any writer, whether it is an RC or whether we are reading a paragraph to solve a para completion, definitely that paragraph is going to have an underlying idea. Not necessarily that it will be hidden only. It is expressly written. So we have to basically remember that idea and we need to complete the paragraph. So a little bit practice and a little bit knowledge that basically what the question wants, we will be a champion of this topic. This topic is very simple. Master it once, know it once and boom. Never ever you will fail in this topic. This is such an easy topic. Right? But it seems to be easy. But we all know that everyone have to practice. Right? Now, in today's lesson, though, trick wise, there is nothing called slides in which trick number one, this, trick number two, that. Okay. Nothing called that. We will be having not much, but three questions. So where in between, I will try to show you that, okay, this is what we need to exactly do. See, sometimes the para completion question takes the form of para summary. Both are different, but sometimes they look same. How? Sometimes what happens, the option that they give, they want us to summarize the entire paragraph and mark that option. Basically, what is this para completion? Basically, it is nothing but a paragraph is given with the last line as a dash, and that dash we have to fulfill with selecting the right option ABCD. Now, that dash, it is a characteristic. There are certain skills, there are certain characteristics to do a para completion nicely. I will actually, let me take one slide here. Okay, a blank slide. In a blank slide, I will just write it down. Right. Now, coming here. So, the first thing that a para completion looks for, a para completion, when we have that passage and we have to fill the last line. The last line, always remember that it should work as a full stop. Full stop to what? Full stop to the discussion. What it means? It just means that whatever option we will mark, that option is going to stop the discussion there only, because there might be a different option that might open up a different level of discussion further. But we have to think about that option that is closing the discussion right away there, means that line should not actually leave any further scope of discussion. So it should be a full stop to that paragraph. Line should be like this. Of course, we have more things. That particular option that we will select, it should be a summary to the paragraph. Preferably, the last line should work as a summary to the entire paragraph. Sometimes it becomes a direct para-summary question. Why? Because it has to summarize. Or even if it is not actually summarizing, if the options are not given in such a way, then we have to keep these two things in mind. If you forget the point number one, it's not about particularly you. Many aspirants do this thing, that sometimes they forget that the last line has to work as a full stop to the discussion. How? Don't know. Looking at the point, it may be summarizing the paragraph entirely and nicely. Acha, one more thing I will add here. Okay, I won't add a slide, I will just write it here only. Just keep certain things in mind. Certain things in mind while you select an option. What to keep in mind while we select an option? We have to see whether the passage, okay, whether the option. Now I just forgot by taking all the things. What we have to, the options has to be either 100% true, then you will select. If it is 100% false, you know that is not the option. And the confusing point is that if it is not clear whether it is 100% true or 100% false, look whether the points are going too broad or too narrow, then it is false. If the points are going too extreme, right, out of the box, out of context, right, too narrow in terms of what the passage was talking, but the options are talking too narrow, or the options are going too broad, or the options are completely alien, completely foreign. So these kind of things we have to keep away from. We have to stay away from these options. It means, and yes, one thing more, that the passage should be its last line or its summary, whatever you call. It should be same in terms of tone and in terms of tense. So the tone of the passage that is already given to us and the options that should work as the last line, their tone should be in a similar way. For example, if the passage is moving in a casual tone, its last line should also be in a casual tone. It cannot be a formal tone. Or if the passage is moving in past tense, of course the last line also needs to be in the past tense. So these are two certain tips I will give you here, that is important, that is to be known, and these are something that we have to apply. Now let us do some practice. We have three questions today. Para 1, after that two practice questions more. Right? So just let me refresh it from my side so that I can see the comments. So hopefully now the slide is visible clearly. let us now do this paragraph. Okay, what this paragraph has for us, what this paragraph says. Okay guys, let us read. So it says this, so as to support. Achha, it starts in a weird way, isn't it? So okay, so as to support offers of toys now and again other than the pinnacle deal time. What? Okay, let us read it once again. What does this author want to say? So as to support offer of toys now and again. Achha, so author want so that we can support offers. Achha, offer of toys now and again. So maybe it is talking about selling of toys or sale. Offer means what? Offer refers to maybe if we twist the word somehow, we may come up with a more accurate meaning, isn't it? Other than the pinnacle deal time. So, achha, so a time where pinnacle deal happens. Pinnacle means the top. Means that the offer author of this RC might be wanting to say that other than the pinnacle deal. Achha, what can be the pinnacle deal time? Maybe author is talking about the season in which more sales happen, the time during which more sales happen. So as to support offer of toys now and again. It means that if we want to sell more toys, okay, maybe author is like kind of running toy shop because toys written everywhere. Author is saying that if in the off season or in the off time when toy do not sell much, if in that off season, if we want to increase the sale of our toy in comparison to the sales season. I'm using the word season. I don't know I should use the word sales season or time, because pinnacle deal, pinnacle means top deal. When the top deal happens, top deal time. So we can actually say the sales season, isn't it? Toy producers take response to the utilization of a few procedures. Achha, so whosoever are manufacturing these toys, these toy manufacturers, they respond to utilization of a few procedures. So the, or you, we can just directly say that toy producers have some few procedures. The way that toy manufacturers are manufacturing toys, they have certain few procedures. Okay, we have to actually focus here now on the main idea. So whatever the author is saying, whatever way the author is expressing, we are concerned about exactly what the message of the author is. Rest of we will do it by the options only, no worries. Further it says, a portion of these incorporate advancing character toys, achha, from Bollywood and Hollywood films or TV arrangement. Okay, so it means that the toy producers who produces this these toys, a portion of these toys are produced from Bollywood and Hollywood industries. Maybe they produce toys on, let us say, some Krish kind of toys, or maybe like Hollywood Spider-Man, Batman kind of thing. They get inspired and they make toys on that theme. Okay. Every one of these sets are showcased as collectibles for the youthful shoppers. Okay, and when these Bollywood, Hollywood kind of the toys are made on these things, then it is like they are like presented not just as a toy. They present them as collectibles for excited shoppers, for the youthful shoppers. Youthful does not exactly and necessarily means youth or children only, because it is not exactly written that it is for children or it is for the youth. It can be toy like, okay, it's like a normal thing. So they want, when they create toys, when the toy manufacturers create toys, they create toys in a way that they portray it as collectible, that hey, you should have collection of all these things. Make sense na? Then, the accumulations inside a group of collectibles be that as it may, never seem, achha, by all accounts, to be finished, particularly to the guardians. The accumulation inside a group of collectible never seems to be finished. Just ignore this line, things goes clear. It means that when they are introducing these collectibles, na, the toys, that hey, this is also in the... So we can just imagine that when a toy manufacturer is creating Batman, so along with the Batman, they will also create all those whatever he is fighting with, his rival will be also there, and some of his supporters and all that. So the whole story is there, whole character is there, mentioned, naming them as collectible. So they are saying that these accumulation, these collectibles, they seem to be never ending. Means they are introducing the collectible in such a way that hey, you just have the Batman, but you don't have this. Oh, I should have that. So collectibles, so the toys they are making in such a way that it is not ending. Okay, a series is not ending. More and more are coming. Okay. Further, when every one of the characters are obtained, achha, the tag at the point requires the related devices and what is this? Thingamagics. What is that? That are packaged into a collectible set. So let us see, like we see that we don't know what is this, na? Gaming, well, even if it is a word or if it is a typing mistake by me, okay. So one thing is there, that what this line want to say, just let us just try to decode without knowing the meaning of this one. So this line want to say that the when someone is obtaining, is purchasing all the collectibles, okay, then it becomes a collectible set. Huh? So this is not new. Further, what they say? Along these lines, guardians go out to shop for the vehicle, the home, and the manufactured home, and even the plane, to guarantee a glad, simple condition for the toys. Okay. Now we can relate it with those Barbie toys, isn't it? That the guardians go, maybe it is like a toy, these are toys for children, small, small kids and all. So they will be like, okay, I have this doll or something. Although doll is not written, but yeah, we can just relate it like this very easily. Okay, and for the doll, now we need a car. So go and purchase a car. For the doll, we need a home. We need a manufactured home. We need a plane, this and that. So toys never end. Collection never end. Okay, then further. At last, similarly, as the slippery last bit of arrangement is achieved, the producer and advertiser discharge the following arrangement of collectible. And what happens that at last, every bit, everything, okay, all kind of arrangement is done. Then the producer, and means everything is manufactured, everything is introduced, then the producer, then the advertiser, they discharge the following arrangement of collectibles. So then they leave this as a collectible. Okay, okay, whatever. So passage was a little bit confusing. Why it was a little, actually this is, we cannot call it confusing. We can call it that the passage, the way it was written, was a little bit different to understand. Since it is different, we can say that the passage was full of a little bit resistance. But it was not that much full of resistance, because if we will keep our calm and cool, we will understand it. So of course that this is a para completion question. So in the next page, definitely we have the options that is going to help us to complete this paragraph. Before doing that, let us summarize this entire passage that we have read, to understand exactly what is the message of the author. Well, up to now we can say that, we can say only this, that the message of the author is about the toy producers. the toy manufacturers. In order to increase the sale of the toys, they do what? They are trying to not only just introduce one toy, because if they will introduce one toy, let us say it's a child, the child will come with the parents, purchase the toy and boom, right? Then the child will, after a few years, the child will grow up then, okay? So in order to retain them, they are introducing collectibles. Collectibles inspired by movies, Hollywood, Bollywood and TVs. So they will introduce collectibles and they will sell it as a collection. When one collection is ended, then they will introduce something that is supporting that collection. So the collection in actual is never ending. So this is what the passage wants to say, isn't it? So now we have an idea. Hello Vishal. Okay, no worries, you are not so late. Okay, it is just one paragraph and we are just learning how to deal with it. I just told everyone that we need to be a little bit careful. We need to look at the idea basically of the RC, basically of the passage, right? And based on the idea, firstly we should know the main message of the author and the option that we will select to complete a paragraph should act as a full stop and act as a summary and not more than that. So we are going to implement these in this question. Three questions we will take today. This is the first question, right? Little bit, if you have missed, you can just replay the session after it. So let's continue and look at the options. Main idea is this, that how the toy manufacturers and toy sellers sell the toy by introducing everything as collectible, and they can introduce collectibles after collectibles, means this after that, that after that, and people are purchasing it all to complete that set. This is the general idea. Okay, now the prime point, okay, the prime point of the maker and advertiser is to guarantee that, this is a para completion question only, but the question is written in such a way that it is not looking like a para completion, right? It is saying that the prime point, or you just call it the main point of those toy producers and advertisers, is to guarantee that. What they guarantee? Well, as per the passage, so they just guarantee that they will provide the adequate collections of everything, isn't it? Well, now let us look at the options and let us try to answer it. Guys, you can also leave your comments and try. Okay, it will be better if we will all do the answers together. So what is this first point talking about? All youngsters ought to be cheerful and no kid can be glad without a total arrangement of toys. All youngsters have to be cheerful, okay, and no kid can be happy without a total arrangement of toys. Acha, always remember that we are solving a sentence completion. Theek? So why I'm saying is because these four points, don't take it in a way that you are solving an RC, you are not solving RC. This point has to be something that we can add in the RC that we have just read. जो passage हमने अभी read किया है, उसका last line होगा इनमें से कोई एक option. So what can be that last line that we will use in that passage, we have to find, right? तो या तो ये point हो सकता है, हो भी सकता है, नहीं भी हो सकता है. Let us read the second point. Second point says, when one set is finished or practically total at the point, total, अच्छा, the following one touches base on the scene. हैं? Okay. Okay, whatever it is. अच्छा. Now, what about the third one? Youngsters ought to be urged to finish their accumulations of toys. Well, marketers won't say that they have to finish their accumulation of toys. They don't want that more and more toys should be purchased. Deals should be falsely supported consistently. Should the deals be falsely supported? Okay. Well, what is your point? What is your say in it? let us just solve it and let us just do the thing solving stuff. Well, when we say that youngsters ought to be able to finish the accumulation of toy, no marketer and advertiser will say this, and the passage is also not talking about it, that they should finish their accumulation. They will not, but the main point is to guarantee. Achha, what the marketers and advertisers will guarantee? They will guarantee that deals are falsely there? No. They will guarantee that you should finish your accumulation of toy? No, because this is what the parents will say. If the marketers will say, then the people will stop purchasing them, and so they will not make further profits, so C cannot be there. Then talking about the A and B, B is when one set is finished at the point falling one touches base on the C. And if we talk about A, all youngsters ought to be cheerful, and no kid can be glad without a total arrangement of toys. Well, if we go with A or if we go with B, A makes better sense, so we will go with A. Why? Because marketers and advertisers guarantee what? They will guarantee that you should be happy. And how you should have, you can be happy when you have the total arrangement of toys, when you have the complete arrangement of toys, then only youngsters will be happy. So again, this is one of the way we can do a sentence completion. How was the question? I think the question was a little bit weird. Chalo. The next two questions are going to be simple and not like this, because the next two questions are actually I have taken from certain past year papers. Let me arrange it. What happened? It went down. Now it is good. So this one is, let us read this, and this is from a very old paper, not I think CAT or ZAT it was. Well, whatever, I don't know, but okay, whatever. So let us read this one and solve this one. Okay, now it says the Asad regime depends on its patrons in Iran and the Iranian backed Hezbollah militia in neighborhood Lebanon. Okay. So there is an Assad regime where? There is an Assad regime. Okay. Who depends on some people who are its patrons? The pattern is there in Iran. And there is one Iranian band, Hezbollah militia, is there in Lebanon. It means that in Iran there is Assad regime, and in Lebanon there is Hezbollah militia. Okay. The Sunni led opposition. Achha, which one? This one or this one? Okay, we have to see. The Sunni led opposition is similarly turning to its regional patterns. Okay, so which one should be the Sunni led opposition? Because it is turning to its regional pattern. We can't say here, because Assad has its pattern in Iran and Hezbollah has its pattern in Lebanon. One of them is the opposition, and not up to now it is not clear that which pattern, which one they are talking about. So one of the opposition party is turning to its regional patterns. Okay, further, these regional players with their own agenda will keep pulling Syria apart until a functional national government can be re-established. Okay, so these two regional players, they have their own different agenda. Okay, and they will keep pulling Syria apart, keep creating conflicts there, and until a new functional national government is re-established. Okay, so although it is not clear that who is the opposition, of course both are opposing each other, isn't it? So Assad regime or Hezbollah, whosoever is opposing each other, whatever it is, but until and unless a national government is re-established, okay, these will keep on opposing each other and pulling Syria apart. It is written. Okay. Now we have one blank here that can be serving as a last line. Now always remember what points I do talk about. The last line should be a summary of the paragraph given to us, or if it may be a summary, or even if it is not a summary, it should work as a full stop. It should not introduce any third point. It should not introduce any new idea. Of course, the third point will complement the second point. The second point says that it should work as a full stop to the sentence, and it should not take us in any different direction. Okay, so now let us try to solve it, and let us try to get directly to the answer. What does this one say? The resolution must be political. Achha, which resolution were they talking about? Any resolution in the passage? No, the resolution was not. Resolution must be political, but grounded in a realistic assessment of the difficulty in putting the pieces of Syria back together. Make sense? Why not? They are saying, because see, last point is talking about we need a government there, isn't it? So its end point should also talk about basically the government. Why will it take any discussed and closed chapter open, reopen? Why it will do that? It won't. So this may be the answer, but let us see other points. Right? What does the second point say? The regime has seemed equally bent on division. Which regime has seemed equally bent on division? Does it make sense? Firstly, to no. Secondly, if B will be the last line, in that case, it will open up a new level of discussion whether really that it is an equal bent. How can you say that? And then a new level of discussion will get started. That is though we don't want right now. So B cannot be the answer at least. A has a chance, but before going with A, let us see C and D, which is better suitable. C says, what's happening in Syria isn't an insurgency now, but a sectarian civil war. Now C is saying something very different that the passage didn't talk about. I told you that the last line should either summarize the passage, but it should not introduce any new idea, because a new idea means a new level, a new world of discussion. We have to stay away from it. So we cannot go with C. Why? It is opening an entire new level of discussion. It is talking something new that the passage was not talking about. So the idea is completely alien. I told you, either it will be too broad, too narrow, or an alien idea. We have to just stay away from it. So this one is also one of that. Sorry. Then, the country should enter what is similar to quarantine until it is cured from the sectarian disease. Sectarian disease, achha, similar to quarantine. What is quarantine? Was this quarantine word explained anywhere in the passage? No. Point number D is also talking about something that is actually alien to the passage. The word quarantine, sectarian disease. What? Which one you are pointing as disease? The passage didn't point anything or any sect as a disease. So how can an option do that? So it is very foreign in nature. So alien things, foreign things, again out of topic. So we are actually left with A, and of course, yes, A is the answer to it. Done? Yes. Now, this one is done. Now let us move to the last question for today. Okay? And hopefully after doing these questions, your concepts will be clear. My only motto is just to show you here that these are the type of questions that are being asked in the exam, and certain ways are there to deal with it. And if we exactly know what we have to do, we do the things in a better way. That's what I am saying. Just doing some adjustment, isn't it? Adjusting it will make it look better in terms of solving. Okay, now it's done. Everything is visible. Yeah. Now coming to this small passage, one more small and the last passage. What does this passage say? Nasiruddin Shah. Okay, it will be interesting, isn't it? Nasiruddin Shah. Last passage, small passage it is. Okay, and let us see which option summarizes the passage correctly. Nasiruddin Shah is undoubtedly one of the best performers on the Indian screen. Okay, despite his atypical looks, he managed to make a mark for himself in both parallel and commercial films, but gives credit to Bollywood megastar Amitabh Bachchan for paving the way for unconventional looking heroes in the Indian film dom. Done. So what can be the last one? That's it now. So, okay. So what was the rule? Let us just try to have an idea of the passage. And what will be the last line be? The last line should not open any new way of discussion. The last line should try to summarize what the passage says, and the last line should basically talk about the passage, same tone, no different tone, these some of the things, and it should not open a new avenue of discussion. Actually, it should wind up the discussion and close it there, and basically it should not uproot anything that was discussed previously in the passage, in the previous side, not at the later part. So again, things depend on the passage, but let us see the options first. First option, Nasiruddin's own. Acha, so what was the topic, what was the idea of this passage? So it is talking about the actor who is undoubtedly now highly renowned, and his looks, okay, actually the passage is talking about his looks are described here as a little bit unconventional, and but still with his unconventional look he was able to manage to get into this industry, and today he is a very big name that he credits this his entry into Bollywood to Amitabh Bachchan. Okay, so what can be the last and the further line? It should be anything that will end the passage here, not lead to any further discussion. It may summarize what this passage says, but no further discussion. Discussion should end with that line. Now let us find what line is suitable. Nasiruddin's own achievement are no mean feat, but despite 3 national awards, international honors. I will stop here. Why? Because just we discussed that the option should not talk about something that the passage didn't mention about. Passage didn't mention about these awards. What awards, honors, acclaim he won or didn't won. Passage actually didn't talk about it. So this cannot be the last line, isn't it? Because even if this will be the last line, then you see the seasoned actor wonders why he isn't seen as commercially viable artist. From where this is coming? This is completely new thing. Passage was not talking anything related to this, that what the actor feels. The actor is successful and the actor credits his success to Amitabh Bachchan. That's it. This award and all these things, these are not written in the RC. How can the option say this? Option is saying this. Of course, the option is wrong because we have to find the last line. This cannot work as a last line. This is not there in the passage. Okay. Idea should be present in the passage. Idea repetition is acceptable. right? But something very new, we cannot add. Chalo. Point number B, what it talks about. Nowadays, unconventional looking actors, acha, like Nawabuddin Siddiqui and Irfan. From where Irfan has come? Problematic or not? This is a problem. It is not even necessary to read the RC entirely. Because the Irfan, okay na, theek, whatever it is. But when the passage didn't mention Irfan, why will we include his name from our end? That is again an alien thing to do. Isn't it? This is too broad in scope. Too broad. Means including the name of one more person who was not even talked about in the main paragraph given to us. We cannot include the name of Irfan. That is too broad. Only two names were discussed in the RC. How can a third name come? So, of course, this cannot be the answer. Have raised the bar in Finland, but Nasiruddin feels the real credit goes to Amdavud. See, point number B, except the word Irfan, everything is perfectly in sync with the passage. Here we have to keep one thing in mind. Although point number B is almost eliminated just because of the word Irfan, but if we ignore the word Irfan, the entire RC is correct. I mean, entire line is actually perfectly summarizing the RC, and this can become the last line. So what to do with it? For now, I will say don't just directly cut the point, although we have a complete reason to ignore this point. But in case point number C and point number D do not make sense, we have to go with point number B, just because other things are in sync with the RC, with the given passage. Let us check C point. Mentality has not changed. It is just the audience has always appreciated good acting. See, about the people's thinking, about the audience mentality was nowhere talked about in the RC. So if it is nowhere talked about in the RC, how can we talk about it? Means people's mentality was where it was, where it is there. It is nowhere. So it is come. Now, talking about the point number D. But the tendency has not changed. Still the chocolate face is acceptable. Who said that? Who said that the things have changed or not? The passage is just saying that despite his looks, he managed to make a mark. But was it able to change something or not? Passage is not talking about it. So guys, we are cutting D. So here, point number B is perfectly representing the passage. Now you will say, ma'am, what about the word Irfan? Because you have said that is out of scope. If we see this like this, like this way, that actors like the word example is given Siddiqui and then another example Irfan. Okay, understand. I know that the second example was not discussed. But here, example form was not being discussed, but the last time example is discussed. But if we ignore the second example, take the first example that is already there in the passage and read everything here. Point number B is that which is perfectly representing the passage. Not adding something from outside, not saying something meaningless, not saying something that is not into the purview of the passage. Point number B is perfectly summarizing the passage. That's why, guys, para completion, sometimes we call it para summary. Either you use the word parasummary or you use the word paracompletion. Most of the time, if we have to do the same thing in same approach in both the questions, people interchangeably use the words. But of course, when we say paracompletion, the last line is just like a blank. And when it is a parasummary, they don't give the blank like this. They will just say what is the summary. At least this question worked as a summary because point number B was a summary because A, C and D couldn't qualify to represent the passage perfectly and end it perfectly. Right now? So this is this. Hopefully you got some insights from these three questions that how to deal with such kind of question. I know that question number one was quite tricky. Rather, it was full of resistance. Highly full of resistance. Language used was such that the coordination between the words was very difficult. Not difficult, was very different. Not because the words used were difficult. The way the sentences were constructed were a little bit different. That's why. But, okay. Second and the third passages. Sentence construction was easy to understand. So you see that we did it nicely. Right? So that's all for the two questions and that's all for the lesson. I'm teaching live on Unacademy Plus. Go to Unacademy. Go to the Unacademy browser. Go to the plus button. Or I will ask you to download the Unacademy Learning app. See all my courses. Go to the plus button. Visit how the subscription courses are working. See all the top educators, when our courses are running, what is the next course coming, what is the course structure, see everything, then take a decision. I am also teaching on Unacademy live and if you want to know the referral code, here it is. So that's all for today's lesson. Let us meet tomorrow with the topic finding the misfit sentence. Thank you guys. Have a nice day.